Hey guys, it's MJ from Endless RVing, and in today's video, we are going to give you a nice close look at the 2020 nuCamp Avia. You are not going to want to miss it.
Izzy here, we are again with nuCamp, the Avia, and we are here with Jackie from nuCamp. She's the resident expert, not me, so I'm going to ask her some questions and she's going to guide you through all this. So we are getting a lot of questions about this from our subscribers, and you explain to us because this is like your newest model.
Yeah.
So let us know, like, what is like this, what's the big deal with the Avia?
Okay, so everyone knows us for our teardrops and our Cirrus truck camper, so we wanted to venture into a bigger game, and I think we've done a really good job with it. So what you're looking at is our latest model. It's a 24-foot box, 28-foot tip-to-tail. From the outside, you're going to have two standard 20-pound propane tanks. Your tire storage is in here as well. You can store your sewer hose, whatever. It does come standard with an automatic jack and leveling system. Outside, you're looking at some good construction. You've got your Asdell walls, plasteoform windows. These are really, really effective. They're dual paned acrylic, just like in all of our other campers. So they're about a third of the weight of glass and very durable and highly insulated. This is one of the many ways we can keep our trailers so lightweight.
Yeah, just talk about the weight, right? So this is 20 foot box, and how was the overall?
It was a 24 foot box, 28 foot overall tip to tail.
And what's the actual weight on this, the dry weight?
5,100.
So guys, so that's pretty low. That's gonna be like a small pickup territory, even like a bigger SUV. You'll be able to pull this. You'll be within your weight, no problem. So that's pretty cool.
You've got a storage compartment over here, which is also accessed from underneath your dinette. Outlet, you do have an automatic awning, which is awesome. It comes with a wind sensor, so if it becomes too windy, you don't have to worry about having to run inside, or if you're not at campsite, it'll withdraw itself, which
I
is
see
good.
There's LEDs running under that?
Correct, yep.
Okay.
We use all LEDs throughout all of our products.
So all your markers, everything's LEDs.
You've got your lighted handle, and then of course our signature nuCamp door with our little cool trash can.
That looks very similar to like what's on Airstreams, right? Like a lot of them have that. I guess on the small package, you're trying to use as much storage as you can.
Correct, yep. So we are so used to packing so much into a tiny little package. So same thing we did here. Utilize the door space. You have some, your window shade and a little bit of storage up here as well.
Cool.
And you're gonna notice that throughout the trailer as well. We utilize every corner that we can.
All right, awesome.
All right,
Why don't we go maybe on the other
side?
Okay,
yeah, we'll go around
and
to the other side.
And then I know there's some people trying to get out.
Locking them in.
Yeah. What I do like, you said it's dual 20-pound tanks, right?
Yes.
So a lot of times on these trailers, you're going to see 30-pound tanks, which I guess is good because you have a little more storage, but when those tanks go empty, you got to get them filled up somewhere. These, the 20 pounds, you can go to like the Walmart or the local gas station and just swap them out. So sometimes people don't think about that.
What's really cool with that is if I was taking this with the kids and I, and it was a 30 pound, I'm really strong for my size, but I don't know if I'm that strong once they fill it up. So the 20 pounds are more manageable.
Yeah, and yes,
well.
They're more manageable, good point.
You've got all your standard RV stuff out here, your city water connection, your Aldi vents, your electric hookup, your coax cable, black flush tank, and then your external shower with your hot and cold water as well. You do have access from both sides. So we've kind of used it for storage down here for the show,
nice
but
size,
it goes all the way through, yep.
Pass through storage.
Absolutely.
And now this is manual stabilizing jacks?
It's going to be electric, right?
Electric
up in the front,
stabilizing jacks,
correct.
Okay. Yep. That's nice.
It does come standard with solar, 210 watt, and then a backup camera as well.
And I see if you look here, a lot of the trailers, they don't have like, it's not capped off nicely in the package, but a nice like fiberglass bumper in here, which is pretty nice.
We're going to finish everything from tip to tail and make it really pretty.
Now, on the tanks, and you may or may not know this, what are the capacities on your black, gray, and your fresh?
Okay, so your fresh tank, you're looking at 42 gallons. Your black tank's 39, or I'm sorry, your black tank's 41, and your gray tank is 39.
Okay, cool.
So this also does have your Aldi radiant heat and flow system, which I said earlier, I might not say it, but okay. I will say, it's going to give you some unlimited hot water, but I say that lightly because your tanks aren't unlimited. So you're still gonna wanna be cautious of how much water you're putting into the
tank. So just so the crowd understands, it's unlimited as long as you have enough propane, electric, and water, yep, right? Yep, so if you're on city water and you have your electric, you gotta keep spitting out hot water. All right, thanks for making that clear. So we're on the inside here, and I just gotta touch, the air conditioning's not on right now, and it's about 85 degrees, and the way this is set up, the windows, we're getting like a crazy cross breeze through here, which is pretty cool. You want to touch on that?
It just feels amazing.
Yeah.
It actually is cooler in here than when we're standing outside
totally.
Right now. We don't even have the fan on. So we've got an awesome skylight. This is probably one of my favorite features in this area. If you open up this one, we have the front window open as well, both side windows, and this one is really only cracked. The air is just sucked in and then goes through to the back, and it feels great in here. So if you are going boondocking, or if you're just taking out and you're not hooked up to electric, don't worry, you're not gonna sweat to death.
And now you have one air conditioner here, right?
Correct. You've got a 15,000 watt BTU air conditioner right above your head. And then in the bedroom area, you have a 3-speed dual directional fan as well.
So I see in here, you got some speakers, you have a lot of outlets, and then you have like this booth dinette. Does this break down and have another function?
Yeah, absolutely. So this dinette is going to function into a bed area as well. Cool part about it is it's so big, it's almost the same size as the back bed.
Okay.
So you could fit two adults comfortably.
Very nice.
The speakers that you see are going to be controlled by this, the radio system, which is right here, pretty digital. It is hooked up to a subwoofer as well.
Okay,
so you really want to jam.
Every
once in a while, we get it going in here, you know.
And now, do you want to talk? This is very, the shape of the cabinets is pretty cool.
Yeah.
Like curved. So, you want to touch on that?
We refer to that as European style.
Yeah,
so we
have
a lot of our style from clearly Europe. Very awesome. We do all of this in-house though. So these are manufactured out of Sugar Creek, Ohio, right in the heart of the Amish country.
Okay.
So the majority of all of our workers are going to be Amish. And if you know anything about them, they take a lot of pride in their woodworking skills. So we get the lumber from a local lumber company. It's cut through our CNC machine. It is stained, assembled, and installed all in our factory. So essentially, we have our own woodworking facility as well.
And there's a lot of storage in here.
Yeah, there's a lot.
This is a small unit, but there is a lot of storage. So
we're really good at fitting things.
Yeah, even though you got a small unit, look how they make use of the space. They hide the microwave in here, convection microwave.
This is pretty awesome too. It's not just convection, it's convection, broil, grill, air fryer, you know, the standard defrost as well. But what this does is it makes it possible that we don't have to weigh down the unit even more with a stove.
Right.
So you can do it all right here.
You're manufacturing, thinking about weight and portability.
Correct. So that's another way we're thinking ahead and cutting down weight.
I see also here you have a 3-burner cooktop.
Correct, yep. So you've got your 3-burner cooktop. Lots of storage still down here. Our gift to you when it's purchased.
Nice. And you even have is that a vent fan?
Yep, you've got your fan and your light. More storage down here. You've got some spice racks. Refrigerator. This is also part of the refrigerator for larger items. You have your freezer down here, or up here as well.
And this is not common, just for the subscribers out there.
Okay.
This right here, usually you have a small freezer. It's not common to have a pull-out like that.
Mm-hmm. I can just see all the lunch meat and hot dogs. Like that's
and then you have a spice rack.
Oh, more spice rack. Let me go back to the spice rack. Oh, just put that one more. There we go. Nice.
And they also see you have a Jensen TV, a bunch of USB plugs. Very cool.
So you've got, this is a 24-inch, and then there's a 28-inch in the back
nice.
For the bedroom area.
Nice.
You've got a little wardrobe closet. Also, you're probably not going to be able to see it from your angle, but over here is going to be your glycol. So when you stick your head in there, you can actually see the level of your glycol, which makes it easy to
That's
monitor.
That's what's heating everything, correct?
Yep.
So you don't have like the classic gas propane furnace.
Correct.
You're using almost like a hydronic system,
yep.
like on a higher end motorhome.
Hydronic
almost.
Radiant heat. That's how I always describe
Very
it to
nice.
People.
Very nice. Now, what we think is pretty cool is how
right.
you make.
Now we're gonna get into this
how you
area.
Make space of that bathroom.
Yep.
That's pretty cool.
So this is our first unit that's not a wet bath. So we have a dry bath. So you have your shower. with a skylight, which also allows for a little more headroom, some taller people to get in there as well. I never have that problem.
Okay.
You have your bedroom, which we'll go over that in a second, and then you have your bathroom privacy area. So the cool thing about this, a couple of things. We make use of all the space, so you have your fold-down sink when you're brushing your teeth. Obviously, you have your medicine cabinet, everything over here. Very nice. But my favorite part is when you're sitting down, I'm not real tall, so I'm good probably right about here. So I can just close it up if needed.
Cool.
But if you're a little taller, you can push it out even further.
Oh, do that again. That was very cool.
So I'm fine with it right here, but if you're a little taller, you can just push it out a little further.
That's a very cool.
So you have so much, you know, people see it and immediately think, how am I gonna fit in there? But it moves out. And then when you're not using it, you can just store it away.
Very cool.
Yeah.
And you have a little pocket door here separating.
Correct, yep.
The two.
So we've got one on each side. That
like
way,
some of your lower end trailers, you would just have like a curtain, but here you have like wood doors, which is pretty awesome. Actually, I just noticed you have like a ceiling tray up top too, which is pretty cool.
That's gonna house our three-speed fan that I was telling you about earlier. So you've got storage again. You're not short of any storage in this area. You've got some USB plugs over here as well. We all know those tablets or cell phones need to charge. Reading lights, but the cool thing about it too is, don't judge me, I'm just gonna do this so you don't have to do it. The bed is electric, so you can be in the reading position or you can put it down, you can put it up, however you guys choose to lay. There's storage, again, it can go all the way down.
Very cool.
If you wanna sit and watch otherwise. And then your second TV is gonna be over here as well. So when we were talking about the cross breeze also, you can look around and there's three big windows in here. All of our windows are gonna come standard. I take that back. Any window that opens comes standard with our Horax bug screen or privacy shade. And you saw the light go down right now. So if you put all three of those, it really does get dark in here.
And I'm looking here also, even on the top, you're spending no space, you're giving space for storage. I also like the detail with the LEDs that are on the bottom shooting up. It really brightens everything up in here. And then again, on this fan on the ceiling, you could easily just stuck a fan in there, but nuCamp went above and beyond and they actually put like a tray with some LEDs to really dress it up nicely, give it a nice classy look. I also see you have some reading lamps.
Yep.
And more speakers.
The back, there you go. So you got blue, or if you want it, you've got your white inside.
Very cool.
We take a lot of pride in the quality that we put in. So we use only the best partners or the unique partners that work for us and have the same vision. So the Aldi heating system, the Asdell walls, the Horax window shades, the Jensen Entertainment. So all of these things, the LED lights, they all work together and help make one amazing product for the customers. And we really are proud of the feedback that we're getting from the Avia. So
can we just step outside and get a couple questions
about
how much this costs and how somebody can get it?
So we're back outside. I just have a couple more questions. You've been so kind and spending your time with us. So if somebody is interested in this Avia, what dealership can they get it at locally? And like, what's the price?
Okay, so right now we're at the Tampa RV Super Show. So our dealer around here is gonna be RV World, Grzinny's RV World. Right now we are, our MSRP is around $60,000, but of course they have awesome specials going on if you purchase it here at the show.
Show price is $49,900. They can't see that price, but we can, all right? And then like, so, you talked about the build quality and how much pride that your workers take in this. So what kind of warranty are we looking at when somebody purchases something like this?
So you have a 1-year tip-to-tail warranty and a 3-year structural warranty. The best part about us is that our quality is amazing. so we rarely see any issues. But we pick our partners, Grizzenny's RV World, based on their customer service as well. So we work really well with our dealers to make sure that any issues that you do experience are taken care of. But we're excited to see more of these out on the road and just start camping in them.
Awesome, guys. So by popular demand, we brought it to you, the Avia by Avia. Sorry, MJ's correcting me. The Avia by nuCamp. Jackie, thank you for taking your time.
It was a pleasure.
And for myself and MJ, who's behind the camera as usual, we thank you guys. We'll see you on the road.